We've watched this play out we've watched it very closely with Janice Dean, senior meteorologist at Fox News, who has been one of the families that has been so personally hit by this story, because it was her in-laws that were in the nursing home, one of these nursing homes. And of course, they were subjected to this edict that was put out by Cuomo's administration. And she's been incredibly transparent. She's talked about this. She's told this story. I don't, were it not for Janice Dean, I really question whether or not Americans would be as aware as they are of what really happened in New York. And throughout all of this, and this is why Janice is so amazing. And for those of you who don't know her, she is one of the most genuine people in this industry, because it doesn't matter right or left. You have some really weird people in it, but Janice is true blue, and she's exactly what you see. She's one of the sweetest, kindest people I've ever met. And I'm not surprised that she came out with this book and throughout all of it. It's called Make Your Own Sunshine, Inspiring Stories of People Who Know How to Find Light in Dark Times. It comes out in March. And Janice Dean joins us now via Skype. Janice, God love you. You are such an inspiration, and you are a force, woman, a force to be reckoned with. Congrats on the book. And thank you so much for joining us today.
Well, I want to thank you as well, because there hasn't been a lot of media attention. I've been covering this governor for about 10 months now, and it's only fairly recently that we're starting to see the CNNs, the NBCs, the ABCs, following this story. So I thank you from the very beginning for not wavering and covering this governor and playing those sound bites of his that just make all of our families crazy.
I can only imagine how this has been for you in the perspective that you have, because this is your family. That this is not anecdotal. This is your family. These are people that you love. Yeah, and I've seen some of the things that his office has said, the way that they've kind of disregarded you and other families, and comes out with this book. And do you think that the pressure and the criticism that is now starting to build from his dust-ups with Ron Kim and some of these other locals, and now there's a documentary filmmaker who came out and said, oh, absolutely, he bullied and threatened us. Is this going to be enough to maybe push him out of office, do you think?
I don't know. I talked to a recent reporter in Albany recently, and he told me that Cuomo is known as the Terminator. Whatever happens, it kind of bounces off of them. But I think even the Terminator was destroyed at one point. So
it was, yes.
I think it's possible. I will say that I read one of the polls today that I think over 60% of New Yorkers believe that he is at fault when it comes to the nursing home. So it's starting to sink in, even though, his popularity is still pretty high, considering all that has gone on, especially over the last 10 months with the nursing home issue. But now that you said we've got Democratic lawmakers coming out across the aisle, joining Republican lawmakers and saying, this guy is a bully. He's been a bully for years now. He has threatened me and my family, and really starting to see the fact that we've got lawsuits now. We've got the federal investigation happening, the FBI, and Letitia James, our attorney general, who is a Democrat here in New York, coming out with her own investigation into the governor and the fact that he covered up the total number of seniors that died.
Yes. And I hope that, and I, knowing from what I know of James's reputation, she's not going to let it go once she starts pursuing this. And it's good to see finally that other people are looking into this, because we can't ever have anything like this ever happen again. And there's just no assurance with someone like Cuomo in office. I wanted to ask you about your book, because this has been a rough year for a lot of people, but for your family in particular. And throughout all of this, you come out with one of the most uplifting, positive titles I've ever seen. And you're using these stories of struggle from other individuals as a way to inspire people to overcome their own hurdles. And I know you always seem like a very joyful person, never in short supply. But I think that this is pretty incredible. And I'm saying this most genuinely, because I don't know that I would have been able to find that much joy within myself to write something like this. And yet you did. And I want you to talk to me about this and how this was the culmination of this past year.
I started writing the book before the pandemic, but most of the book was written in the pandemic. We were sort of forced into this situation. All of us as Americans were in quarantine. And this book actually helped me going through some of the darkest periods in my life. Just talking to these people, some of whom are, you know, just regular folks like you and me, who just did kind things for others. That's the basis of the book, is people shining a light on others with their own kindness, or doing something to help someone, and never really wanting the attention for it. You know, one of the stories that I talk about in the book is this FedEx driver who sanitizes a package because he knows there's a compromised little girl in the house that he's delivering to. Things like that, that deserve our recognition and deserve to have a book written about them, you know? And so I would say this book was meant to be not only to bring to you and the audience, but to help me go through some of the darkest days that I've ever gone through. So that's what Make Your Own Sunshine is about. Is it's not about going outside and seeing the sun. It's about making it for yourself.
I love that. I absolutely love that. And throughout all of this, I'm sure you've gotten to know a lot of these other families that are in the position that you have and that you're in, and have made some fast friendships and long lasting bonds. Talk to me a little bit of just about maybe some of what are people not paying attention to in this scandal, and what would help you and these other families the most for other individuals who are not in New York, and we're watching this just aghast from afar and really rooting for you to get justice and your families to get justice and prevent this from happening again. What can we do in our limited capacities to help?
Well, listen, we're not going to get an apology from this governor. I've given up on that. I think at the very beginning, had he started that, I'm really sorry for your loss. Maybe if he had written condolence cards or made some phone calls instead of writing a book during a pandemic. Right now, families want answers. We haven't gotten them. What are the origins of the March 25th order? Why did he put infected patients into nursing homes? Why didn't he use the federal government facilities like the Javits Center and the Comfort Show? Why did those go empty? And why did he cover up the numbers for so long? You know, I think once we get some of those answers, if we're going to go down a road of, I believe, you know, criminal intent with this governor. And I really hope that we get to the bottom of it, because at least, you know, we'll have those answers. And like you said, no other family will have to go through something like this again.
I hope so. And I hope you get those answers. And I would like to hear from even the administration on something like this. Maybe, I don't know federally if there's any kind of regulation that could prevent something like this from happening, to where, you know, we at least have a standard of how to house and treat and triage patients like this. And you made a really good point with the USS Comfort, because that ship, I think it was not even up to half capacity. There were only a few people that were actually treated on that ship, and it was brought for that singular purpose, to help alleviate and prevent these kinds of catastrophes from happening. Janice Dean, congratulations on this book. And we're rooting for you to get the justice that your family deserves. And I have to say, I think, and he ought to be, Andrew Cuomo ought to be terrified of you, because you are just a beacon of truth. And you're just so courageous. And we're fangirls, and we just love that you are just going out there and you're fighting for truth, because it seems that in this era where truth often can be, you know, kind of whatever anybody wants it to mean, you're just really out there fighting for truth and fighting for accountability. And I think that's all anybody's ever wanted. So thank you for doing that. And we're praying for you, and I can't wait for your book to come out.
I know you're praying for me, and I love you, Dana. And thank you. Thank you for all your support from your family to mine. I really appreciate it.
Of course. Thank you. Janice Dean, everyone, from Fox News, and her new book, which is out next month, Make Your Own Sunshine, Inspiring Stories of People Who Know How to Find Light in Dark Times.